using this program, I'll show you that when you implement two-dimensional array using dynamic memory allocation scheme, then row 1 and row 2 are stored at different memory addresses. I mean, row 1 and row 2 are stored in a different memory areas of heap memory area. Okay, now the program is exactly the same. Only see the for loop. Here in this for loop will display the content of some ij, then their hexadecimal address, then their decimal address, and lastly contents. Okay, similarly we'll display using this for loop the content of SAM 0 and SAM 1, I mean their addresses and content. And in this printf statement will display the address of SAM, hexadecimal address, and its content. So let us run this program and see the output at DOS prompt. See, here is a proof. You see the array 1. So this is your row 1 and this is your row 2. So row 1 is stored in a continuous memory locations, that is from 1778, next one is 1780, and third element is 1782. So there are row 1 is in continuous memory location. But now you observe row 2. After 1782, you see there is a gap. So this one is 1794. So SAM 10 is stored at 1794. Okay. But after that, row 2 is stored in the continuous memory location. So 1794 plus 2, that is 1796, plus 2, that is 1798. Is it clear? So remember that row 1 and row 2, they are stored at different memory location. Though row 1 is in continuous memory location as well as row 2 is a continuous memory location, but both these two rows are not in a continuous memory location. Okay, now observe one more interesting point. Here SAM is stored at FFDE. The address of SAM is FFDE. The address of SAM 1 is this one. The address of SAM 0 is 06EA, and addresses of all the six elements are different. Okay, so this means they are variables and they are stored at different memory locations. This was not the case when you implement the array, two-dimensional array, with the help without the help of dynamic memory allocation. Okay, now you observe one more point. Here SAM address is FFDE. The content of SAM is 06EA. This hexadecimal address. This means SAM is pointing to SAM 0. You see, content of the address of SAM 0 is 06EA, and the content of SAM is 06EA. Hence, SAM will point to SAM 0. Clear? Now you observe the content of SAM 0. It is 06F2. This is the address of SAM 00. You see, the content of the address of SAM 00 is 06F2, and the content of SAM 0 is 06F2. Similarly, you observe the content, the address of SAM 1. It is 06EC, and the content of SAM 1 is 0702. This is the address of second row, that is here. You see, 0702 and 0702. So SAM 1 is pointing to this array, this row. Is it clear? Understood the memory management? Thank you.